فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
Very very strong effect of sin. Very clear effect of sin is the knowledge you have of the religion begins to diminish. You start forgetting what you know. You learned the Quran, you learned something, you learned a few ahadith, you learned rules, you learned regulations. You begin to lose it as a result of sins that are committed, as a result of not fulfilling your prayer, as a result of not fulfilling the obligation Allah has placed upon you, as a result of eating haram, as a result of that which will displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being done, you start forgetting. And when we forget the knowledge, guess what happens? You lose khashiya, you lose concentration, and you lose the beautiful taste of worship. So a person who is engrossed in a sinful life, he doesn't want to pray. It's such a burden. It is such a big burden. He or she doesn't want to dress appropriately. It is such a big burden. Notice I said he or she, because it's also he, not only she. You know, people think that rules regarding clothing more for women. The answer or the reality is, do you know, a lot of the time some of the young boys wear tight clothing they're not supposed to be wearing. They show half their backsides. They're not supposed to be the case. They want to show off their chest, saying that it's only from the navel to the knee. That's not true. You need to cover respectfully in a dignified manner as a believer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So it becomes so hard to dress properly because your life is filled with sin. Subhanallah, knowledge is gone. You find it so difficult to make wudu, like it's a burden because you're doing something wrong. That's the reason. So Allah takes away the sweetness of acts of worship from a person who sins. And remember, I'm not going to go into every sin and what it is, because the list of sins is endless. Endless meaning so many things people could do. Sometimes a deed that appears to be good can become sinful if the intention is dirty. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us cleanse our intention. So to have knowledge snatched away, to have the sweetness of worship snatched away, then one sin leads to another. When you start committing sin, initially it doesn't feel like it's something so serious. Or should I say, initially it feels like, you know what, this was just a one-off, I'm not going to do it again. When you do it again and a third time, it becomes easier to sin. That's a result of the evil effects of the sins that a believer engages in. It becomes such that you just feel like carrying on. From this sin, you commit another one, and then you say, by the way, I am committing that. Let me just go into here. I went into the nightclub. Now there's alcohol. Let me just drink. Now that I'm drinking, there's a bit of drugs. Let me just do that. Now that that has happened, the adultery comes with it. Let me go. Before you know it, you are drowning in so many different sins that you feel that you are now at the end, because you are depressed, you are stressed, you are sad. So much has happened, and at the same time, you actually feel within you that, you know what, there is so much of darkness in my life. This is why the door of Tawbah is opened. I know I will speak about it towards the end, but I need to mention it just in case someone dozes off near the end. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us.